Hello everyone. How are you all doing today? I hope you are all doing good from wherever you are watching this video from. I am doing great from my end and I want to welcome each and every one of you to our YouTube channel. If you are new here, kindly remember to subscribe to this channel and also turn on the notification bell so that every time we have a new video, you will be able to get notified. And for our returning subscribers, thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate all of you. Now, I'm here to share another story. And, you know, Kate Middleton would dearly love to go to Wimbledon but can't promise anything. That is basically the heading of the story I'm here to share. And once again, I want to say you never know the strategy they are trying to put in this story. On the 4th of July, Andy played his final match at Wimbledon, and the Scotsman was the first British man to win Wimbledon in 77 years. He won that twice, and he picked up gold and silver medals on center courts at the London Olympics. Wimbledon gave Andy an incredibly emotional ceremony on center court with a lovely video package and some other legends of the sport coming out to pay their respects. You know, who could not be bothered though? Wimbledon's royal patrol, the Princess of Wales, that is Kate Middleton. I still remember when she skipped Wimbledon's lovely centenary event in 2022. Well, 2 days after that, Andy's retirement, Kate posted on Twitter. To be fair, someone on Kensington Palace social media staff also posted something on the 4th on their Instagram stories. And I also feel like, to be fair enough, Kate said Andy was supposed to play a mixed doubles match on Saturday with Emma, but Emma pulled out, and maybe Kate Middleton originally intended to come out for that. While I understand Kate is still going through cancer treatments, there was an excuse for skipping that event in 2022, asking that, because now the health issue came in after 2022. It was basically this year. And it's like Royal Patrol makes a point of skipping the biggest moments for Wimbledon and British tennis. But anyway, I just saw something shared by the Daily Beast comment from a friend of Kate. And maybe I share this with you. That hopes are high that Kate might stage a dramatic return to the Royal Box on center court a week on Sunday for the highlight of the week, the men's final, and present the winning trophy. A friend of Kate and William told the Daily Beast, it is no secret that she would dearly love to be there, but when you are having chemo, as herself said, there are good days and bad days. A lot depends on the timing of the treatment. She made it to Trooping the Colour, so if she can make to Wimbledon, she will. That is from the friend. And now, I just feel like a lot of things are happening and, you know, first of all, I thought that the way they planned for Trooping the Colour, and I remember the media were like, you know, we might expect, we might not see her, we might see her, you know, such kind of things. And one thing I learned about the media is that they were so aware. They knew that Kate was going to show up during that event. And now it seems the same thing is here, repeating itself. Here we go again. They are trying to build up another momentum similar to Trooping the Colour. So Kate Middleton has yet to use her platform to promote any cancer charities. I just imagine, you know, the media always talking of, we are expecting this and maybe she will not be there because of the excuses given, the health issues and stuff. But once again, I learned that This is just a way of preparing people that, you know, we will see Kate Middleton during this day. So this is just a plan, a strategy, maybe to get the most attention. But I want to say, at the end of the day, it will not win. Because every single day I see Kate Middleton showing up for something, even before the health crisis, I have seen her trying to use some strategic plans. But at the end of it all, it is always a flop. So this means that she will be at Wimbledon soon. The pages from PR book are so tired now. So I promise we might see Kate Middleton. And do you know what actually came to my mind after reading that? It's because Harry is yet to receive an award and these people are trying to look for a distraction. They are trying by all means to make an appearance, to make someone who has been away for the longest time to now show up, to overshadow, because they have seen that their cry are not being heard. They really wanted Harry to decline the award. They wanted that, you know, ESPs to consider someone else who is not Harry. But after the ESPN made that statement, you know, they said, Tillman Foundation honors Harry for the award. So the plan is they want to overshadow the event. They really want to make up something else to just distract Harry's event. Maybe something like that. I don't know what you think about it. That is per my own opinion, because I have learned a lot from these royal family members. They are used to such kind of things. And it's not shocking. This is not the first time and it will not be the last one. Every single day they'll do something whenever Harry is planning for something. And Harry recently, we had seen the photo of Harry with the boss of Better App. Harry busy working without even commenting on such kind of critics. But some people, these royal family members, are planning for the worst behind the scenes. I can say that. You know, whenever you have learned of someone who is capable of doing something to overshadow the other party, then it just comes out clearly that whatever they are planning together with the media, that must be something they know. The media are so much aware that Kate is yet to make an appearance. Just like trooping the color, it's here once again. So this is the PR. And anyway, we will be here to see if they will get the spotlight they have always been crying for. Because I don't think there will be anything positive in that. Kate Middleton thinks that everybody misses her, but no. So I don't know what you have to say about this. What do you think about the media talking of such kind of things indirectly? Tell me in the comment section if you think the media are aware of what is going to happen or they are not aware. So kindly comment down below and allow me end it here. Remember to subscribe, like, and share. Until next time, goodbye.